Hey everybody, this is Mason with VB Services. I'm here today to show you a little bit about Claris Connect, the newest product from Claris. And what it is it's a platform that allows you to integrate with lots of different services, makes it really easy. It works really well with FileMaker and lets you integrate all these different services, make workflows that work together, and does it really easily. So what you're looking at is the dashboard when you set up your first Claris Connect. What you get is projects and templates. So there's some pre-built templates to do a few things. I've already got a project set up for my article. So a project is just a grouping of flows or workflows. So you'll notice I had this this test already, so which is what we'll be building today. So what we're going to do is build a PTO request form in FormStack, which I've already built, that lets people put in their information, fill it out, submit it. That's going to go to their manager. It's going to be emailed to them. They'll have a chance to approve or deny the request. And then if it's approved, it's going to create an event in Google Calendar, and it's going to create a record in our PTO request table in FileMaker. So normally I'd say that'd be very hard to do, but Claris Connect makes it pretty easy. So let's go ahead and make a new flow. Let's call this PTO request. And you'll notice that not all of the services are highlighted. Some of them are dimmed out. This is because not everything has a trigger. So like Box has triggers for all these events and has all these different actions you can do. We're going to be integrating with FormStack, and it has one trigger when a new form is submitted. So we'll just keep with that. You can connect a new account by clicking this, and then you just sign in and authorize. I've already done it, so I'm just going to select this existing account. And I'm going to go ahead and pick the PTO request form that I've already created. And to continue, you need to fill out the form once. So we just go to PTO request. Just fill this in. We'll do a request from the 17th to the 22nd. Looks good. You'll notice like almost instantly the connection is complete, so we can save that. And the reason we need to do that is so when we do further actions and steps, we have that data available. It basically sends the start date, end date, notes, all this information that we need so that we can continue working. So what we're first going to do is format the dates a little bit. We need to format them so that they can work with either Google Calendar or with FileMaker. So I'm going to just format these dates real quick. I'm going to go through this pretty quickly, but you'll notice I click this button here. This button lets you have access to previous steps data. So I'm going to pull from FormStack, and you'll notice all that data is here that we sent. And I want the from date, and I want to format it in a format that Google wants, which happens to be the very last one in this. So we'll save that. And it's very helpful to rename these. So we'll just call this Google from date. And then we're going to do it again for the end date. So pull from FormStack. Last one, and rename. All right, and we're actually going to do it two more times for FileMaker just because they like their data format differently than Google does. So again, just go through this real quick. You're going to want month, month, day, day, year, year, year. Finally, for the end date. All right, so that's all done. All right, so now that we've got our form submitted, we've formatted our date, the next thing we need to do is send it to be approved from the manager. So to do that, there is a utility called approval, and we're just gonna make a new one, and the title will just say PTO request. The description will say, we'll just say who's requesting it. So Mason would like time off from to, and you'll notice we're not using these yet because we haven't actually submitted this flow yet, so it doesn't know what this data is going to look like yet. But we've already submitted the part with the form stack, so we can use these. Just pass along the notes that he filled, that the user fills in. All right, so who do we want to send it to? I'll just send it to myself for now. But this information could come from a drop down where you select your manager so that it gets the email from that. So it could be dynamic. All right, so this is the requester name. Do that, space, and then the last name. And we'll give ourselves 3 days to respond. All right, so we can't really go any further till we have submitted it again. So you'll notice by default it is disabled, our flows are disabled. So we'll just go ahead and turn that on. And we'll go in here and we're gonna just submit this again. If we look at our history, we'll see a pending one. And that's because we haven't filled out we haven't approved it yet, the manager hasn't. So this came from FormStack itself, so that's not exactly what we want. There we go. Oh wait, no. Sorry. Let's give it a second. Make sure I typed in my email correctly. Okay, so I get my PTO request. I can come in here and say, sure, sounds good. I'll accept that. And now if I look in my history, I should see a success, which I do. Perfect. All right, so now we need to do an action if the status is approved. So we'll do an if. We want to know if our approval status becomes, if it's approved, just type that in there, and we want to do text equal, we'll do case insensitive, so we'll save that, and we want to do an action if it's approved, so if the condition is true, and we want to, let's create the record in FileMaker first. So create record, to connect to FileMaker, you can connect a new account if you want, and you just type in the domain, user, password, and database. You do need to make sure that the data API is enabled and that the file is hosted, but other than that, it's really easy. I've already done it, so I'm gonna select that. And what it does is you actually pick a layout. So I've gone ahead and made a PTO request layout, and this is the data that I wanna fill in. So I come over here, I find that layout, and there are my same fields. So now I just need to start populating the data. So most of the data, some of the data is going to come from the form stack for the email. The date, we want to use the formatted, this is the end date. So we want FileMaker end date, start date, our from date, and our status is going to come from the approval step. So if it's approved or not. Our manager note comes from our approver comments right here. And our user note came from FormStack under the notes. All right, so that is all we need to do to create a new record in FileMaker. While we're at it, we're also going to make another action to create our calendar event. So I'm going to select Google Calendar, and we're going to do create an event, the advanced. We'll continue. Again, you can connect to that, make it really easy. I'm just going to select an existing one. And then we just got to fill in some information. So the calendar, we want to do this one. We'll say true on notifications. So what time does it start? We want to use our Google start date. And we'll just fill this in manually. And when does it end? Okay, so the event name, we'll say time off, and then who has the time off. So for Mason, the description, I'm just going to leave that empty. You can fill it in if you wanted. And then finally, this is filled in. Google has a whole bunch of different things you can do for reoccurring events. We're just going to delete all that because we don't want our PTO request to repeat. So I'm going to save that. Alrighty. So we've done all of that. Now we just need to submit something. So what we can do is we can go to our history and we can actually resubmit. Instead of going here and resubmitting and doing it all over again, we can just click replay and it'll rerun a previous attempt. This makes it really useful for testing. So what it's doing, it's going to keep here and wait until we've actually got the manager approval. So we've got that new request coming in. Yeah, why not? We'll accept that. All right, so over here. All right, something went wrong replaying your flow. So let's go ahead. Did we get an error? I think it worked. Let's take a look. When did we request? 17th. Yeah, I mean, it created my event. That looks good. And created my record. Yeah, it must have been a false error. Let's see over here. There we go. Yep, showed up underneath my PTO requests. All right, yeah, so that's basically how flows work. There's a lot you can do with them. Very powerful. There's a ton of services. And it makes it very easy to integrate with anything. There are definitely some difficulties and things that are challenging, but overall, it just lowers the barrier for entry to allow anyone to integrate with all sorts of services. We're very excited about it. If you need any help getting this set up or working through any issues, definitely let us know. We'd love to help you out. And that's it. Thanks.